Hello everyone and welcome to another video. Today I will tell you the best combo for every map in the game. So let's get into a friendly battle. And as you can see, we have Gem Grab, Solo Showdown, Duo Showdown, Trophy Escape, Heist, Bounty, Brawl Ball, all the modes. We will go through everything. So this will be a bit longer video. I will give you some timestamps in the video so you know exactly about what mode and what map I'm talking right now. So let's get started right away with the probably most interesting mode for you. Solo Showdown. I will give you the best no teaming brawler and the best teaming brawler. About no teaming, it's absolutely Surge, no talking, best no teaming brawler on this map. And with teaming, it is Shelly. You can farm your super, you know, you have great star power that gives you bonus HP. Nothing really counters you. If we talk about tanks, Shelly, great teaming brawler. Scorched Stone. This map is new in the rotation and the best no teaming brawler here is Buzz or even Carl, because you can rush the middle with your gadgets, get all the cubes, and then you can get one by one because of your cube advantage. The best teaming brawler here is probably Mac. She has a lot of HP, good range, the map is open, so Mac is a very good teaming brawler here. Beast of Famine. The best no teaming brawler here is Duck, in my opinion, because he has the damage gadget that can one hit people. You can rush the mid, you can get all the cubes. So there's a lot of no teaming brawler that you can play here. Also like Jesse. I wouldn't recommend Buzz, to be honest, but also Shelly. You can also play Shelly here without teaming. You can play so much more. You can play Rosa. So there's a lot of options because this is a very aggressive map. And the best teaming brawler here is Buzz and Shelly, I would say. With Buzz, you can join the middle, click your gadget and team with other buses. And with Shelly, you can also farm your super, play on the outside of the map and get to the middle in the late game. Double Trouble. So this is the map where you can play the most brawlers right now. And the best no teaming brawler here is Melody. You have so many dashes. You can engage. You can get away. You have a great shield gadget. The brawler is strong itself. You can open chests quite quick. And yeah, so Melody, great no teaming brawler here. And the best teaming brawler probably also like Mag, but you probably can also play like Gus here, even when Gus is not the best Showdown player. But I really recommend playing like a high HP brawler on this map, which includes Mag. Island Invasion. This is also a very aggressive map, and the best no teaming brawler here, in my opinion, is Cordelius. Cordelius is a great brawler here, counters many brawlers. You can do a lot with Cordelius on this map. You can play in the bushes because you can see with your supercharge if someone is nearby, but that works better with Buzz, to be honest. But in the late game, Cordelius is so strong, can counter all the Shellys, all the tanks. And the best teaming brawler here probably again something like Bo, Shelly, or maybe even Cordelius with the person you team with. You can just super and get away or whatever, or engage someone. Stormy Plains. So here, this is a bit tricky. You also have a lot of no teaming options here, and I would say even a brawler like Dynamike. Dynamike is very underrated in Solo Showdown. He has huge counters like Mortis, Miko, Edgar, etc. But you have a jump star power, so you can do something if you're a good Dynamike player. But if you're like not the best player in the game, then I recommend playing brawlers like Surge again, or even Shelly. Shelly also a great no teaming brawler here, or even Cordelius again. And about teaming, it's again brawlers like Shelly, Buzz, Cordelius, and also Melody works here because Melody is a great Showdown player since she has high mobility. Safety Center. So here, the best no teaming brawler probably again Cordelius, Melody, Shelly, Surge. Again, many playable brawlers here. It's a very good map in my opinion. And you can also try some new stuff. You know, you don't always need the OP brawlers. You can also play something like Stu, even if he's really not that good, like Surge or Melody. But he's still playable here also. Maybe even Edgar, if you're like not on rank 30 elo, but a bit lower, then you can also play Edgar here. And the best teaming brawlers here are Cordelius and Shelly. They often team with each other and try to get some kills here. And Marksman Paradise, obviously the best no teaming brawler here is Angelo combined with Piper and Nani. And the best teaming brawler here, some high HP like Mac again, but you can also play in team as a Piper, even if it's a bit harder. You know, you're quite squishy and you can be backstabbed easily. You can also play something like 8-bit. I've seen 8-bit teamers here. I have seen Gus teamers here. So as a teamer, you have more options with your brawlers, but I recommend really playing something with high HP. Gus, for example, also has a great shield, so brawlers that don't die too quick. But let's get to Duo Showdown. I recommend playing a brawler here for sure. It can be any thrower. If I say thrower, it can be just any thrower, you know. It can be Tick, it can be Sprout, Grom, Larry and Lori, etc. So just choose the thrower that you like the most. It can also be like Dynamike, you know, or Barley. And your teammate should play a brawler that is quite fast paced and has a lot of mobility. That can be Melody, that can be Edgar, Buzz, for example, brawler that can collect the cubes and save your thrower. What you can also play for every Duo Showdown map is Kit with a good brawler, for example, Kit combined with a more Mortis, Kid combined with a Thrower, Isera. So Kid is also one of the strongest brawler in Duo Showdown, so you can also play some Kid combos. So now we have Scorched Stone. I really recommend a brawler like Karl or Buzz that can rush the middle instantly and get as many cubes as possible for your team. And a second brawler really should be a Sniper, something with range that can be Brock, that can be even Leon, that can be Piper. So really choose something that has some range because the map is more open. And if you already have like a Karl or a Buzz in your team, you really want some range in your team so you can't get pushed by anyone. Feast or Famine. I really recommend a brawler with vision here. For example, Buzz or Bo, Terra. Terra might be the worst of them. So he can rush the middle and something that is really good at holding control, or even another brawler with vision. So you can play like Buzz and Bo, for example. Or you go for something like Buzz and Shelly. So you have a tank counter, or Buzz and maybe even a thrower. I don't really recommend that, but you have many options on this map, but make sure you have some vision on your team. What you also can do is playing from the outside, so you can also play a safer combo. For example, you play Terra and just save your gadgets for the end game, or you can also play Buzz and save your gadgets for the late game, or even something that breaks the map, for example like Brock and Piper. So you're going crazy with this and, you know, you just open the map if you can. So there's a lot of strategies here, but I personally recommend using combo that is good in the mid and at least try to get some chests there. In Double Trouble, I recommend using two snipers or one sniper and one assassin, for example like Piper and Leon. I don't really recommend using a tank here. You can always play throwers in Duo Showdown, but I think having something like Angelo here is really great, combined with the Piper or something. Piper can break the walls, open the map. Angelo can walk on water, so you have a lot of mobility and options here. I think that's a great combo for this map. Island Invasion, same thing again. I would use something with vision. For example, a Buzz might be necessary here, so you can run through the bushes. Buzz only clicks his gadget if it loads from someone in a bush. You just instantly activate your gadget and then you check out who's where. And as another brawler, I would say you use something like Shelly, or even something with range like Bo, or maybe even a high DPS brawler like Cold or whatever, something that can do a lot of damage. And combined with Buzz, you can make some quick kills in the bush, but are also not too weak in a late game, like a double tank combo that just gets countered by Cordelius or Shelly instantly. So choose something that makes sense. Stormy Plains, I really recommend a thrower here again, and with a thrower it should be an assassin again. Buzz, Leon, Mortis, Edgar. So the thrower is for the control and the assassin is for engaging, getting some chests quick enough, etc. By the way, Melody is also an assassin for me, so you can also play Melody since she's one of the strongest brawler in the game right now. On Safety Center, I really recommend Kit. Kit is very strong on this map, I think, and you have many options with Kit. You can combine Kit with, as I said, a thrower or an assassin like Edgar or Mortis. I mean, Mortis is not the best Duo Showdown brawler, so be careful with that, but it can also be a sniper like Piper, Brock, whatever. It can be Melody. I think Melody and Kit is an insane combo, to be honest, so you might consider playing like Kit Melody on this map. That would be a great combo, I think. And on Marksman Paradise, just play snipers. Play something like Nani, combination with Angelo and Piper. I think you should always have a Nani on your team so you can counter Angelos and Pipers. I think the best comps probably like Nani and Angelo on this map, but you can also play Piper if you want, or any other sniper, but I think that's the best combo. So let's get to Trophy Escape. On Trophy Escape you can play so many brawlers. I even pushed Nita here, so on this map you just play a brawler that can hold the middle as good as possible. I did it with Nita, but you can play much better brawlers like Melody, for example, and just camp the middle and try to get much trophies or build a win streak by camping in the middle. But you can also play another strategy like Shelly or Cordelius, cycling the bushes, running through the bushes and trying to react faster and getting some good kills. But that's a pretty hard strategy. It's really hard to get to the middle and then even escape. So I really recommend playing a brawler that can hold middle. For example, also Charlie. Charlie is great here. I would say Charlie is like the best brawler in this mode and also in the middle. So make sure if you can that you play Charlie here and just rush the middle instantly. Bounce Buzzer. You can also play Charlie here, but this is more like a sniper map. Here you have many options. You can play Piper, you can play Angelo. I would play something with range, absolutely. And I think this map is really great for pushing your snipers. And Circling Sands also gives you many options. Legends. You can see a lot of Shellys here, a lot of Cordelius players. I think Cordelius or Charlie might be the best option here again. You can do great kills with them. With Charlie you can just steal some trophies. With Cordelius, he's like the best 1v1 brawler you can play. So yeah, that's like my recommendation for this map. But let's get to the 3v3 modes, starting with Gem Grab. And about this, I'm like not the best 3v3 player the world has ever seen. So there are e-sballers that have more experience than I do. I'm really good at 3v3, but some people just have more experience and know better what to play here. So I asked some pro players, like e-sportlers, to give me the best combos for this map, and they responded, and this is the result. So for almost every map, I will use the sentence main combo. Main combo means Angelo with the jump gadget, with the heal star power, shield and damage. On Bush maps, you take vision and speed. Then Melody with the shield gadget, the speed star power, damage and shield. On Bush maps, also again, vision and speed. And Charlie with the spider gadget, the slow star power, and damage and shield. Unless you have Bush maps again, then you use vision and speed. So this is the main combo for like almost every mode. But I also have an alternative for you. That means the main combo, like Angelo, Charlie, Melody. But if you don't want to play this combo, or you have it already, or whatever, you have them on like rank 30 or rank 35 or whatever, then I will give you an alternative for each map. So on Hard Rock Mine, we have the main combo, and we have the alternative Rico on the lane with the damage gadget, speed star power, plus one gear and reload. Bell in the mid, trap gadget, shield star power, reload and shield gears, or vision if you want. And you can play Rosa, that counters a lot of lanes, with the slow gadget, heal star power, speed and damage gears, or if you want, plus one. Undermine. Here we have main combo again, but the alternative here is again Rico and Rosa on the lane with the same build, and Piper in the mid with knockback gadget, reload star power, and vision and speed. Even if it's like just 5 pushes, I wondered myself, but the esportler said, yes, it's good gears here. Also, it makes sense for the outside bushes, so yeah. Flooded or flooded, I don't know how to pronounce it, whatever. This map, main combo again, and alternative, Cordelius with the jump gadget and the mushroom star power, plus one and speed gear on the lane. Also Amber on the lane with circle gadget, star power doesn't matter, reload gear and plus one gear. Or you can also play vision. 8-bit in the middle with teleport gadget, speed star power, heal and reload gears. Double swoosh, again main combo. And the alternative is throw with slow and less damage star power, speed plus vision gear on the right lane. On the left lane we can play Sandy with the stun gadget and the damage star power. You can play speed and plus one gear or even vision if you want. It's not that strong on Sandy. And you play Jean here with the knockback gadget and the heal star power, longer pull gear and vision gear. Minecart Madness, main combo again. And the alternative is Sprout on the left lane with the wall replace gadget, splash damage star power, ult charge gear and plus one gear. Cordelius, you can play Cordelius on the right lane with jump gadget, mushroom star power and shield and plus one gears. In the middle, as a good Angelo or any sniper counter, you can play Nani with the shield gadget, shield star power and plus one and shield gears. Acute Angle, you can play main combo, or alternative is Stu on the lane with turret gadget and heal star power, vision and speed gears. Max in the middle with dash gadget, super load star power and vision and speed again as gears. And you can also play Cordelius with the jump gadget, mushroom star power and vision and speed also as gears. Rustic Arcade, same main combo. Alternative is Nani with the shield gadget and shield star power, plus one and shield gears. Gus with the damage gadget, more damage star power, shield and damage gears. Amber with the speed gadget and faster reload star power and reload gear and plus one gear. Open Space, we have main combo again, and the alternative is Spike with the block gadget, curveball star power and the mythic gear and plus one gear. In the middle you can play Eve if you don't want to play Angelo with the jump gadget, big shot first star power, reload and mythic gear. And also Amber with the circle gadget, faster reload star power, and for gears you use reload and plus one. Now we have Brawl Ball, starting with Pinball Dreams. We have the main combo again. Alternative is Nita with the shield gadget and the heal star power, for gears you use speed and vision. Then you have Rico with the damage gadget and the speed star power, gears are plus one and reload for the middle. And you play Willow as your thrower with the hiding gadget, faster speed star power, for gears you use vision and speed. Center stage we have main combo again, and the alternative is Rico with the damage gadget and the speed star power, gears are vision and reload. Sandy with the sleep gadget and the damage star power, for gears you use speed and vision, or even plus one if you prefer having one more gadget. And you can play Buster here with the hook gadget, immune star power, and for gears you use speed and damage. Beach Ball, we have main combo again, and the alternative is Surge with the shield gadget and a stage 2 star power combined with speed and plus one gears. Stu with break gadget, heal star power, and gears are speed and vision. And and Karl with the Flame Gadget, Shield Star Power, Gears are Speed, and plus 1. Galaxy Arena, we have main combo. Alternative is Piper with the Knockback Gadget and Reload Star Power, even if the map is filled with bushes. And we play Speed and Vision here. Stu with the Break Gadget and Heal Star Power with Speed and Vision also as Gears. And Cold with the Break Gadget and Range Star Power, also with the Vision Gear and Reload. And Circlement, main combo again. Alternative is Max with the Dash Gadget and Superload Star Power, Gears are Speed and Vision. Then we have Buster, you play with the Hook and the Immune Gadget combined with Speed and Damage Gears. And Sandy with the Sleep Gadget, Damage Star Power and Shield and plus 1 Gears. Retina, I don't know how to pronounce this map again. On this map, you play the main combo, or the alternative is Rosa with the Slow Gadget and Heal Star Power combined with Speed and plus 1 Gears. Surge with the Shield Gadget and the Stage 2 Star Power combined with Speed and plus 1. And Sandy with the Sleep Gadget, Damage Star Power combined with Speed and plus 1 or Vision Gears. Off the line, here we play main combo again, or the alternative is Lian with the Invis Turret and Heal Star Power, Gears are Vision and Speed. Max with the Dash and Superload, Gears are Vision and Speed. And Cordelius with the Jump Gadget, Mushroom Star Power combined with Speed and plus 1 Gears. Last but not least, Goalkeeper Stream with main combo here again. Melody is very strong. The alternative is Melody again, because you need a Melody on this map. That's the only way. And you can play Piper with Knockback Gadget, so you can counter other Melodies with that, so she loses the ball. Play Reload Star Power and Shield and Damage Gears. Also another great brawler here is Amber with the Speed Gadget and Superload Star Power combined with Reload and plus 1 Gears. We reach knockout, and here the first map is Gold Arm Gulch. We want to play the main combo here with a thrower instead of Charlie, or the alternative is Nani with Shield Gadget and Damage Star Power, Gears are Vision or plus 1 combined with Shield, Rico with Damage Gadget, Speed Star Power, Vision and Speed or Vision and Reload Gears, and Eve with the Jump Gadget, Normal Shot Star Power, Gears are Reload and plus 1. Bell's Rock, we have the main combo again. Alternative is Gray or a thrower in the middle. With Gray you can play Pull and the less damage Star Power, Gears are plus 1 and Shield. On the lanes you play Mac with the Turret Gadget, Knockback Star Power, Shield and Heal as Gears. And Bo with the Turret Gadget, Stun Star Power, Reload and Shield Gears. But you can also play any kind of sniper here, like Piper, Angelo as I said, Mandy, Nani. So you can also play Snipers here, also Bell, that also works. Deep End, here we only have one combo that you should play. That is Angelo, because of the water obviously. Nani with the Shield Gadget and Damage Star Power. Gears are plus 1 and Shield. Damage Star Power to actually one-shot some people to make some kills with her. And Piper with the Curve Gadget. Reload Star Power. Gears are plus 1 and Shield. Alternative, I still give you an alternative, and that's Mandy with the Slow Gadget, Shot Speed Star Power, Gears are Shield and Damage, Angelo is a must have here, and Nani with the same build. Flaring Phoenix, the best combo here is Rosa combined with Kit. Rosa plays the Slow Gadget and Heal Star Power combined with Shield and Damage. Kit plays the Heal Gadget, Sitting Longer Star Power, Gears are Damage and plus 1. And Cordelius plays the Mute Gadget, Mushroom Star Power combined with plus 1 and Shield Gears. Rowing Springs, also one combo I suggest you is Angelo. You absolutely need Angelo here. It's a pure Angelo map, combined with sniper like Mandy, Nani or Piper, and a thrower. Out in the open, we play the main combo, or alternatively Rock with the Break Gadget, more Rocket Super, Gears are Shield and plus 1, Mac with the same build as I mentioned before, but I'll say it again, Turret Gadget, Knockback Star Power, Gears are Vision and Speed or Shield and Damage, and Piper with the Bush Star Power this time and Curve Gadget combined with plus 1 and Shield Gears. On healthy middle ground, we have again the Rosa and Kit combo with the same build. And as a third brawler, you play Ruff to heal your teammates up, or you can also play Cordelius, so you have a good counter to this combo. New Horizons, we play the main combo, or the alternative is Buster with the Hook Gadget and Immune Star Power combined with Damage and Shield Gears. Jean with the Ghost Gadget, Heal Star Power and Gears are Longer Hook and plus 1. And any kind of thrower, like Daring Lorry, Sprout for example. Now let's get to Wipeout. Here we have the first map, Infinite Doom. Here the best combo is Jean with the Ghost Gadget and Heal Star Power combined with Speed and Vision. By the way, you play Speed and Vision on every brawler here. Ems with the Knockback Gadget and Damage Star Power, and Buster with the Hook Gadget and Immune Star Power. On Slayer's Paradise, we play Byron with the Heal Gadget and Anti-Heal Star Power, Gears are Shield and plus 1. Angelo again, and Nani with the Shield Star Power, Damage Star Power and Shield and plus 1 Gears. The alternative is Nani in combination with 8-Bit and Angelo for for maximum damage. So you can surely make kills with the Nani super. Shooting Star, one of the most popular maps. Here we have Angelo, Nani and Piper with the same builds again. Alternative is Angelo, Max and Jean with the same builds again. On Snake Prairie, we play Bo, Terra and Shelly. Obviously Bo with the Vision Star Power, Terra with the Vision Gadget, Shelly to counter some tanks. And you play the Turret Gadget on Bo with Speed and Vision obviously. Speed and Vision for every brawler. For Terra you play the Heal Shadow and for Shelly the Snipe and Slow Gadget and Star Power. So now let's get to Heist. On Heist we only have 4 modes. We are starting with Safe Zone, main combo again here. And alternative is Chuck on the left lane that can just place the stations and rush the safe all the time. But as I said, Charlie is a great counter to this brawler. You can play Nani in the middle for an Angelo counter with Teleport Gadget, Shield Star Power, for Gears you use +1 and Shield, and Eve for the right lane with Jump Gadget, Normal Shot Star Power, for Gears you use +1 and Reload. GG Mortuary, we don't have the main combo here. You can play Miko and Edgar that only do damage on a save, and you also play Angelo that can work on the C, who does great damage, can also defend and keep control, so this combo is quite strong. For Miko you use the Slow Gadget, the more damage on save Star Power, for Gears you use +1 and damage. On Edgar you use the Supercharge Gadget, the Heal Star Power, for Gears it is +1 and Supercharge. On Angelo, the same build, so Jump, Heal and Shield and Damage Gears. Bridge too far. Here we also don't have the main combo, but we have Angelo in the middle, obviously. We have Nani and Piper on the lane. Angelo with the same build on Bridge too far. For Nani, we play the Shield Gadget, so we can, you know, counter Piper lanes or Manny lanes, whatever, Angelo lanes really well. We play the Shield Star Power and Shield and Damage as Gears. On Piper, you use the Curve Fever Gadget, the Reload Star Power and Shield and Damage for the Gears. The alternative on this map is 8-bit with the more damage like longer shot gadget, damage star power, and for Gears you use Reload and Heal. You can play Cold with Reload Gadget, longer range star power, for Gears you use Reload and Damage, and Angelo with the same build again. You need Angelo or you cannot play on this map. And on Pit Stop, Rico is a great brawler with the damage gadget, the damage star power and +1 and reload gear. You use Spike here with the damage gadget, Heal Star Power, and for Gears you use +1 and Mythic Gear. And also make sure you have an Edgar on your team with the Ult Charge Gadget, Heal Star Power, and for Gears you use +1 and Supercharge. Now we reach the Hot Zone maps and we are starting with Split. And we have almost the main combo here, but with Angelo that uses the Shooting Through Walls Gadget. And instead of Charlie, we use Grip here or Stu with the Opening Gadget, Heal Star Power for both, and Reload and +1 Gears. Alternative is Rico on the right lane with the Damage Gadget, Speed Star Power, Gears are Reload and +1. And now we have a Gale and Tank combo. With Gale you play the Jump Gadget combined with the Slow Star Power, Speed and Damage Gears, and any tank you want, for example like Rosa, Jackie, whatever you like to push your tanks with the Speed and Damage Gear or +1 if it makes sense. Also for Gadget and Star Power, make sure you have the most sense making build here. And on Ring of Fire you play main combo, or the alternative is 8-bit with the Teleport Gadget and Damage Star Power, Reload and Heal as Gears. Byron, so you can heal and do good damage in combination with the turret that gives you even more heal. With the Heal Gadget, Shooting Through Star Power, Gears are +1 and Shield. You can also play Pam, by the way, instead of Byron, but Byron is the better brawler. And Amber with the Speed Gadget, the Reload Star Power, and Gears are +1 and Reload. Dueling Beetles, we have Melody and Belle. Belle uses Trap Gadget and Shield Star Power combined with Reload and Shield Gears. And Jesse in the middle with Slow Gadget, Repair Star Power, and Shield and Damage for the Gears. And on Open Zone, we play Angelo and Byron with the Free Shot Gadget, Anti-Heal Star Power, and Gears are +1 and Shield. You combine that with Poco that uses Heal Gadget, Heal Star Power, +1 Gadget, and Shield Gears. So for Basketball, on all the 4 maps, we recommend using Angelo, Charlie, and Melody. Especially Melody, quite strong to make some scores with the Basketball. Charlie is great defense with an absolute OP Gadget, and Angelo just has all the range and damage your team is missing, especially on Green Meadows. Now let me do another sentence for the 5v5 maps. On Gem Grab, I don't give you a full combo now, but I give you one brawler that you need to use. On Gem Grab, it is always Miko in the 5v5 mode. In Brawl Ball, you should always have a Melody for easy scores. And in Wipeout, you should always have an 8-bit, a Nani, a Mandy, and probably maybe like 2 throwers, and yeah, that's it with all the combos for every map. I really hope you enjoyed this video because it took a ton of time to record this and asking so many pro players to give me the best combos for this maps. So huge shout out, thanks so much, especially to Mewtwo Brawl Stars for helping me with this video. Big shout out, make sure to check him out, he's a new upcoming streamer and esportler, so give him a chance, try his channel or his live streams. With that being said, thank you so much, leave a like if you liked this video, a dislike if you didn't. I wish you a wonderful day, your Snakefuck, peace.